Blackstone Audiobooks presents Shoot, Minnie, Shoot, the story of the 1906 Fort Shaw Indian Girls, basketball's first world champions, by Happy Jack Fader. For Zuzu Rose and Texel Lily, my world champions. Five birds fly in her dreams. Minnie fluttered her wings and vaulted into a blue sky, a blue swallow speeding like a beam of light, turning, diving, darting nimbly past pointing treetops, soaring up towards high, puffy summer clouds. Above and beneath and beside her flew four other graceful blue swallows. Though forever weaving about and changing positions, the five swallows moved as if guided by one mind, banking and dipping and climbing in perfect wordless unison. No one bird raced ahead of another by as much as a single flickering flap of blue wing, or lagged behind by as little as a quick blink of a tiny silvered eyelid. They were one bird even while they were five. Minnie marveled at their teamwork. Their random patterns of playful flight ended abruptly when a silent summons swept over them, commanding them to fly to a distant and unknown destination. They veered sharply towards it, unable to resist. Their busy wings would have no rest until their journey ended. The summons now pulled harder at Minnie. It began to hurt. Her resistance was futile. Its call physically gripped her, embracing and tugging at her wings, pulling, pulling, pulling. Something strong and hard clutched at Minnie's leg. Her heart pounded as she forcibly parted the thick veil of dreamy sleep and lunged forward into a sitting position, her eyes open and mind alert. She quickly flung the wool blanket off her leg, and with the moonlight that glowed through the tepee's canvas wall, saw a knobby, muscled hand draw off her leg and disappear beneath a worn buffalo robe. The hand belonged to Lux in Water, Minnie's mother and youngest of her father's four wives. Having unconsciously pulled Minnie out of her restless dream, Lux in Water snorted once and returned to her deep sleep. Minnie rubbed her face in frustration. Ay-yi, why did this same dream return to her so often, year after year? Why five birds? To where did they fly and why? Minnie wanted to know. But a new thought emerged, and she put the dream away for the moment. It dawned on her that she was the only one awake. It was almost as good as being alone, and therefore a moment not to be wasted. She turned and crawled to the darkened fire circle in the center of the floor. Propped on her elbows, she picked up a stick and stirred the lazy embers, added a handful of dry slivers on top. She pulled back her long, loose black hair, leaned near the dark but still warm embers, and blew softly. They slowly pulsed red, then orange, then flickered gently into little flames. They snapped and danced. Minnie's brown eyes sparkled with the yellow light, and her cheeks glowed pink roses. She had now lived through 16 winters. She tossed aside her little worries over the recurring dream, and instead used the lonely moment to pursue her one consuming passion, pondering how to accomplish a wondrous and great deed. Before succumbing to the conquering combination of white people's diseases, soldiers, and endless streams of settlers, young Shoshone men had entered adulthood by performing a great deed. Perhaps they counted coup against the Blackfeet, or stole horses from the Nez Perce, or struggled for months to memorize the elaborate and lengthy rituals surrounding the Beaver Society's medicine bundle. Her father, sees far away, was able to divine the whereabouts of buffalo in a time of great starvation. Also, there were stories, not many to be sure, of Shoshone women who had become warriors. These men and women inspired their fellow Shoshone with their great acts, reminding them of the greatness they were all capable of achieving. If Minnie could emulate the leaders of the past and perform a great and heroic deed, she too would inspire her people.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.